Welcome back everybody to the trading channel of DGRL. Let's continue where we left yesterday. Before we start, by the way, how are you all? I hope you had a great day, great night, great evening, great everything. I hope you're doing fine. And let's start continue where we left yesterday. Thumbs up, please subscribe for the ones that are new and didn't subscribe yet. Comment below, whatever you want to comment, but keep it nice and friendly. That is one thing I ask for you. So yeah, let's just continue where we left yesterday. The trades, as you can see, is still consolidating between the price, the opening price, and the line here. That is a significant. No, that's not really a key level, if you ask me. But it was the high of this one, the highest point of this 4 hour candle. And you can see that it is rejected and tries to break it, rejected, tries to break it, rejected, and basically just on a 4 hour candle consolidating in this area. Well, that is okay, but also not really cool. There is not really much of that. There is a little bit of resistance here, which can become support, but until now it is just resistance, which is basically not really cool. And yeah, if you ask me, this point to that point, now it starts to create a real triangle. And I just hope that this triangle will be traded correct and end up in a plus for us. Although everything can happen from this point on. Still, the prices didn't fall below the 26,000. It didn't went below the 26,300 either, nor it went below the 26,400, which are both good. And as you can see, I'm still in the plus. I had around 10 buck, I think 9 buck earlier today. That was as far as I remember this candle up here, went until this level. This difference here is 400 pip, maybe 3.5 euro. So let's say I had a plus of 9 buck. It was nasty news that came on about Medicorp in America. In the United States of America, that pushed the market down. I'm sure that was a news of yesterday, 19 hours ago. It was pretty predictable, if you ask me. So the time will delete. It was pretty predictable. You can see here on the 50 minutes chart here the big push. Also in the 30-minute chart, it was really, really a nasty push, overtaking all these candles up here. There was also pretty high volume in it, 6,000 only. Compared, this is the let's take the 4 hour candles, 19,000 and 6,000. But there was pretty lot of volume in that 4 hour candle. How much did we have here? 16,000 and it went down. 15,000 and it went down. But there is still an uptrend, if you ask me. Specifically from this point to this candle here, it bounces nice. So it makes a steeper triangle, which usually is a sign to break, and bleh, it will just fall down. I don't like that to happen, of course. Nobody likes that to happen unless you went in with a short position. Then it is of course in your favor. But still, I still have the idea that this would go up. How it will go up, I have no idea. How far? I hope it will just break Break this trend line here in 5 6 hours from now, which it didn't do yesterday. I gave it also a few hours. And what I will say, I will close this trade within a few days from now because I also want to do other trades and do a different strategy. Long term is nice, but you can see what long term can do. You keep paying for overnight, for keeping it open overnight. They gave me a nice dividend. So I still pay $2.9 to keep this trade open now for 5, 8, 9 days, for around 9 days. Somewhere around 9 days. $2.9 for a 0.01 contract. Might be not really that much, but it still needs to earn back. Because that are costs, and you also want to have a nice income over those days. So basically, the trade should end up in at least $50 to have $1 profit a day, which can be translated into $100 a day if you have a 1.0 contract. And that makes it a little bit nice, not what you should expect. And yeah, if you break down those candles here, what also happened yesterday, and you trade on a shorter time frame, on a short time frame, short period, I mean, then you can end up earning a lot of money with breaking down this one, going back up a little bit until this point, and then breaking it down again. But that is high risk trading, and do you know when the market will go down? Yes or no? Yeah, that you can base it on the weeks. This was a nice week already, fooling people that it would still go up, and then after that. Funny part in this case is that this is the market open candle. This is the market open of the United States session, the US session. Candle open, candle open, and every time when the market open, it plumps down like a push. This was the 230. Here you have the 230 candle, which is, yeah, weird. It looks like an indecision candle for me. So it went up in days after that. That was over the weekend, 12th of April, right? Yeah, that was over the weekend, up to Monday. Then we had the 16th, which was yesterday, was not really a good day, and today was also not really a good day. The market went down and down and down, and it's just not funny. Yeah. Anyway, we're still on the upside of this big triangle, which usually is a nice predictor. So it is all based on probability, don't forget that. I mean, really need to know that this is just predict. Not prediction, probability. It's just all based on probability, so who knows what will happen. But yeah, I just hope that it will breach this line up here and just continue to go up. It seems to be nice again. You take the 4 hour candle, it also goes up. It had a higher low again. Now, oh, come on, where is the delete button of this one? Just remove it. Yep. Delete the band. Delete that. The candle is still not finished. It will take another hour. But it is a nice uptrend. It also closed a little higher than the trend line. So let's just hope, no, not hope, I talked already, we shouldn't hope in trading, but let's see what the market will do. To go into on the title of my video, which is of course also important. A long-term trade can end up in a huge profit, like what I said yesterday also, depending on when you enter. If you enter on the wrong moment, yeah, it can take a while for the profit to open, and basically this is just a wrong timed entry, wrong time entry point. You should have been in the market already since a while ago, and then it would still be profitable to stay in. Depending also on what your targets are. Do you have nice targets, yes or no? If yes, then it might be a good strategy to jump in here. If no, then not, of course. What do I mean with nice targets? If you're happy with earning only based on a 0.01 contract, 20, 30 cent per day, then you're still good to go as far as I see. No, not really also, but if it ends up in 1 buck, 2 buck, 3 buck, then you're already in the min. You didn't earn for a few days, which is something that a trader cannot have if you want to pay your bills from it. A full-time trader cannot make a living out of this one. That's one thing for sure. Your costs are adding up and income is not coming there. 2.9 buck is what I paid until now to keep this trade open. 3.09 is it now. If I close it now, I didn't make any money, honestly speaking. It didn't even cover the cost of electricity use that I have right at the moment to make this video for YouTube. So yeah, my idea of trading, it should be intraday, or you should be so damn good that you can make good decisions on when to enter market and when to exit. Or I am just playing the wrong market. That can also be. Maybe I'm just playing the wrong market and a long-term trading strategy for stock, for example, can be a good thing to do. What I am trading here, indices. Yeah, maybe I just took the wrong indices. I don't know. That might be possible. But for the US 30, I see for now it is a really choppy market with not so much of a benefit. Same as for this one, although it looks a lot better, to be honest, than the US 30. Since December, it is in an almost straight line going up. It's also a lower word value than this one. And if you look at the daily chart of the US 30, yeah, it is not so nice as the French one. The AUSTX on the daily chart is also a lot better than the US 30. So I might have just taken the wrong market to pay my to bet on, to place my trades in. US 30 is a nice market, but this also seems to be very nice, honestly speaking. So maybe I will just also trade a change strategy a little bit in the next few days, leaving the market US 30 and just go into FRA 40 or NAS 100. They seem to be a nice playable market also. The 4 hour chart since December seems to be a nice one, honestly speaking. I traded this one already last year in November, as you could see. Making some adjustment strategies on this one, on what it's supposed to do, what it would do. Well, based on those 3 points here again, you had a nice indicator for this market to go down. And then after that, I left it. I don't know why. I started to focus on the US 30. Well, I don't really like to use indicators. They usually give a wrong signal, wrong idea. And trading after a market already formed or making a strategy, yeah, what you see in most of the YouTube videos is not something that I like to do. We are here now. What happened in the past happened in the past, and it cannot be a good predictor for the future. So I usually leave trades with a lot of indicators in it. It is funny to look at, but not something that fits in my strategy. Naked trading is what I like. Just a few trend lines and maybe a Fibonacci that can help. Yeah, we can place a nice Fibonacci chart up here. Here. for example, from December until that point. Doesn't make any sense. But until this point, then all of a sudden we are at 11.8 again. It's being bounced back. It's around the 11.8. If you place it on this one, it's a day chart, so yeah, you should just move the chart also. If you do day by day, it breaks. You can also leave it on this one and still try to break this level. Then I would take the highest level from the past. The highest level from the past in the last 20 days exactly. So that is really a nice nice measurement. Would be this candle up here. And then you can see it is just bouncing on the 11.8. Waiting for it to breach this area up here. Still in line with this, yeah. It might consolidate here for I don't know how long. I don't hope that. I hope that it will just bounce and rise, rally, bounce, or rally, retrace, let me say it like that. To make a nice consistent profit, as you can see also, my 3 buck that was 5 minutes ago is now already reduced to less than 2 buck. But this market is also pretty choppy. Or volatile, I have to say, to keep it under the proper words. So yeah, it keeps being rejected up here. It keeps being rejected here, and that's not funny. If we take a 1 hour chart, what I already did a while ago is you can place a nice line up here. And maybe a line something like that. You're forming some triangle like things. It is starting to enter a new triangle. This seems to form a 90 degree angle, which is, as far as I know, pretty positive because that makes this triangle valid. 90 degrees will be in this way, of course, but who knows. It is being rejected here again. And yeah, what it will do, it's just based guessing. My title, here it's three buck again. Yeah, what goes down goes up also. It's pretty volatile again. Although it is all pretty late. Market is about to close, I think. Or they have lunch, or they came back from lunch. I really don't know, but it doesn't really matter, to be honest. Taking this candle and this candle, yeah, more under 1 hour, a little bit high like this, yep. Breaking it down into small into lower time frames. You can also see that that the scale of the chart also changes. If you do a lower time frame or a higher time frame, it makes it also, of course, a little bit dangerous to make good analysis based from a specific time chart into a lower one, since your lines are not exactly the same anymore. And this would give you an image of a false breakout. For example, for this, it's only a 1 minute candle. Yeah, that must be a false breakout, is what some think. So look out with that. If you analyze a specific time frame, stay on the time frame. That's really important. Really important. And yeah, what this would do, I have no idea. I really have no idea. I was hoping that it would just rally and rally, going up, making new higher highs, but it starts to make new higher lows. And if you ask me, this really seems like a consolidation. The volume is also going down. And that doesn't make it really trustable also to go for another long position. So as soon as I see in the next following days that this Kendall went back. I will probably close it so I can do different strategies. I want to discuss also something about the Renko chart. That might be a nice piece of help. If for MT4, if you want to have a Renko chart, you need to have an indicator. But still, it is an indicator that makes a Renko chart and not not something like Bollinger Bands or moving averages or something like that. But I would think of that. I'm not sure yet if I want to do that. What is important for a trader to do is to use as less as possible, as less as being possible indicators. Don't try to use them, they are lagging and they can also give you a wrong indication. I used a lot of indicators in the past and maybe I used them on the wrong way. Might be, maybe I was wrong informed. But I lost money on it, that's one thing for sure. That being said, I'm also losing money in this way, so yeah. That's not really true, I'm not really losing money, but money is also not really adding up. That's it. I should, don't say I should, but when it was up here, I should have closed the trade. And then wait for another entry point again and you know, set a target. That's the most important stuff. Set a target. If you have 10 buck, which is an equivalent of 1,000 with a 1.0 contract, after 2 or 3 days, be happy with it, close the trade and wait for a new signal to arise. And try to get some knowledge about swing trading. That's also what I want to do. Swing trading seems to be very nice and profitable. The only thing is, how do you know when the swing is already there? Yeah. You might use stochastics, or how do you say that? I don't know. Then you could actually see some divergence that they usually say on the internet. For example, here. But how many pips do you wanna take? It's really important to set a goal. That's one thing for sure. Or you have a better market like this one. I wanna trade also in this market and see how that goes. Because this also seems to be very nice. To trade. It seems to be very steady, more steady than the US 30. And there might be more symbols or up here that are better than the US 30. That I really don't know. We can take the FTS. Do we have this one? No. Daily chart. Some of them have really, a few days ago, they really had an, but it was already a month ago. After that, it was in a nice rally up. The GER30, it is the same. It's also a little bit choppy, but also good. Hong Kong 50 is not really something that that gives money also if you go in for a long trade up here, but usually after a price rally, a retracement will come. This seems to be like some sort of flag. Well, since December, it is all going into a nice, but this is also too volatile. There is the US 30 again. This one is also a pretty steady, nice market. I will just also look a little bit into this. Nice 100 euro, so SPX 500. There are a few markets that I like to see, honestly speaking, and I want to analyze those charts also, and I want to get better in reading those indices. Well, this is oil, and the oil, that's also a good one. CSI 300. I don't know what CSI 300 is. So. Well, the ones who went long up there, it was nice, closing them. So, that's a lot. actually a nice one. Dangerous market if you don't have a stop loss. You would have a margin call, like, I don't know. October, December, yeah, this one's too choppy. And a bunt, maybe the bunt is something nice. That's also a very choppy market. Now, let's see what happens. We are still in this trade, in the week chart, and the week chart seems to be nice. It tried to overcome this candle here. It already overcome a lot. So in the week chart, it seems to be good to me. Although it can yeah, it can bounce back. Eh, this. It was not really a good entry point that I chose. That's one thing for sure. But you learn. The longer you trade, the more you trade, the more you learn, and it's also important. What's more important is that you remember the knowledge that you learned, the stuff that you did. That's why I'm also making this library on YouTube, so we can just look back on trades in the past and how we did it in the past. And did we change a lot in our trading strategy, or did we stay consistent or whatsoever? And that might actually help us also a lot in improving. That's important. If you ask me, that's really important. Because of course, in the end, we want to improve and make this 300 buck trading account into an 30 million or 300 million trading account. And if that is possible to do it ASAP, then we do it ASAP, right? Why wait? Why would we wait with that? Let's be honest about that. But we have to take our time also, that's one thing for sure. This is dangerous to trade too fast and to make decisions based on greediness or whatsoever. That was my mistake, hold on. Anyway, don't make trading, don't enter a trade based on greediness or because you think you could do or something. Just be careful, be careful on what you do. It's really good for your pocket and good for you, also for your self-esteem. It's really important for your self-esteem also, because keep entering trades that will fail after time after time after time, and it will degrade your self-esteem also and make you think that you're a lousy trader or whatsoever. If you're a starter, you might be a lousy trader in the beginning, but keep going, keep learning from the mistakes that you make, write them down or whatsoever, I don't care, but most important thing in this case is that you keep learning of your mistakes and don't repeat them too much. That will make you better in on the long run. It's a good long run strategy. Good long-term strategy for improving your own habits, and that's important to trading. Clear your mind, be easy, and don't be stressed. Absolutely never ever trade because you think it's a quick way to get rich, because it's not. I showed you now already also, if it's a quick way to get rich, I have my trade open now for 10 days or 11 days, I would have been a millionaire. I could have bought my yacht, but that's not the case. It's not a quick rich job. Swing trading, intraday trading, swing trading, high frequency trading, that might be a nice lucrative way to get quick rich. Though swing trading come with a lot of risks, and I don't think a lot of people can buy computers and hardware that can actually perform high frequency trading. High frequency trading is something that costs a lot, and you should also know the programs for that. Find programs and then you might be able to do high frequency trading, but investing in programs like that, if you can even already buy them, yeah, is something that you would earn back. The payback time would be nice, I think. But do you have the initial investment? That's one thing that you have to ask yourself. Anyway, continuing on how long-term trade end up in profit, because that is what we are here for in to begin with. Well, I think we have to wait a little longer and hope that this would rise to 27,000 or whatsoever, and that should be in a small period of time to become real profitable, based on the fact that you also need to pay your interest and your long-term interest, and a weekend long interest rate. Every weekend that it stays open, it's $1, and every night that it stays open is 36 cents. And you do not get every night a dividend, otherwise I would have left the trade open and earn 9 cents, or 11 cents. Is it 5 plus 6? 11. 11 cents overnight. That would actually make me money instead of cost me money, but that's not the case. Believe me, the dividend will be paid once a week, I think, or whatsoever, and it is, as you can see, only a small amount of money. But let's see what happens. Like I said earlier in the video, I might close the trade in the next following days, because I also want to trade different strategies, and I want to make videos that is not only talking and analyzing a long trade, but also deciding when to enter and when to exit the trade. And that is something that we want to learn, all of us. And I would will do that more often. How I will do that is not really something I know yet. Of course, I will push the button, but maybe I will use an external Renko chart or an external tick chart or whatsoever, because the charts here in MetaTrader are not really charts that I want to work with. Although you can actually find the bodies pretty well with line chart. Those are the nice bodies. You can see that this candle going down is not really relevant. But yeah, maybe this line chart might also tell you stuff that can happen. But I think for a line chart, you need to go to a lower time frame. See, that is already something needed. Go to a lower time frame with that, but then you end up in a minute chart, as far as I know. And in a minute chart, oh, you could, okay, that is cool. But are you going to exit your trades instantly when it goes down? Because then you would exit up here, and the spread is also something that is really nasty sometimes to trade with. The spread actually, some decision pulls you in the trade, and then it's the spread that you need to earn back to begin with. And if the trade goes against you instantly, usually greediness will come in, and I will stay in the trade a little longer, and it will go back up, it will go back up, or whatsoever. And yeah, it might not get back up to begin with, so you should have exited the trade straight on. So this is also not really a good strategy, if you ask me. It goes up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. And when to enter and when to exit? Yeah, maybe in combination with an EMA or an SMA or a stochastics. But again, that's also something that I don't really like to use. Line chart up here can be used for the 1 hour, for example. Who would know that this would go down like this? It was overnight. It had a very bullish momentum up here. Very bullish momentum, but it can take it can stay for a longer time than this. I had bullish momentum in the market that kept on for this, for example. This is a 4 hour chart. This was a few days. Bullish momentum for 13 times 4 hours. That's a 16 times 4 hours. No, yeah, it is a little lesser than that, but 12 times. 12 times 4 hours. No. Very bullish momentum. Who knows it would go down, yes or no? It just corrected a little bit, retraced a little bit here, and it went up more. And then it retraces a little bit. And yeah, this signal here is a bearish signal. But it went back up also again. So stochastics also, not every signal that you receive on a stochastic is a signal that should be followed. I still don't know. I can't remember myself on what I based my trade to enter Friday the 5th. Maybe, was this Friday the 5th? 12, 4, 15. Maybe it was Friday the 5th. Was the trade around 4 o'clock? Somewhere around here. Well, I don't know, honestly speaking, because if you look at the stochastics, it was already pointing down here in this area, so that was not really I don't know why I placed the trade. That's one thing for sure. I shouldn't have placed the trade, but I placed it probably placed it around this candle up here after this big rejection. So maybe I'm going to add stochastics to the trade, to the chart, to get confirmation on what we are actually seeing. It might actually be worth it. It's an oscillator, stochastics. Stochastic. No, this actually might still go up. It is retracing a little bit. Yeah, but now I'm starting to add indicators, which I really shouldn't do, because I don't want to get false signals. Hold on. Yeah. I don't want to get false signals based on indicators, which are easy to happen. That's why you can also enter trades based on indicators, but take 4 or 5 indicators, and if they align all properly, then you could enter a trade. For example, the stochastic is up here, it's on a cycle high, so it might retrace a little bit and then go back up. RSI is already above 50. Pointing up a little bit, so you could put a moving average in it. Simple moving average, for example, take a 20, not a 2, but a 20. Also pointing, still pointing up. It's actually a good sign, but all three of them are not lined up. This one is pointing down a little bit or flattening out. Well, this is a little bit pointing up, and this is pointing up a little bit more. Now, if all three of them are going into the same direction, you could go for a long trade that was somewhere around here, for example. This was a nice entry point for a long trade. If you want to be sure, you could have did it up here, this candle or this candle. This was pointing up, pointing up, pointing up. So yeah, anyway, I will remove them because I don't want to trade that much with indicators. Oh, let's go. Anyway, the moving average shows me that it is still in a nice uptrend. For the day chart, of course, the 4 hour chart is already different. This is the 50, this is the 50. The 50 is already flattening out, and that's what you actually see. It's consolidating nicely. And the 20 is also doing the same. And it's bouncing off nicely on the 20, honestly speaking. It's the simple, right? Yeah, this is the simple, exponential. Exponential. Well, that's also still good. But still, 100% for sure is something that that you never know. And this is also pointing up. So the exponentials are still pointing up, and this is already $4 again. So yeah, in the course of making this video, you could have shorted this market for a few minutes, longed this market for a few minutes. Actually, make a buck or two. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And all small things adds up. Eh? That's one thing for sure. Like, and with this broker, I only have to pay a spread. With other brokers, you probably pay $5 or $10 per trade that you place. And depending on that, you really have to make a nice strategy for yourself. It's really important. Do know what you need to pay on your broker for every trade that you make. And base a strategy on that. That's the key factor to make money in the markets. It's really a key factor. Your costs over a period of time, and then the risk that you take over a period of time, the trades that you lose, and then the trades that you win. Your profit loss ratio should be at least, if you ask me, at least 51%, of course, otherwise you will never make money. In the ideal way, it should be 75%+. That would actually make you a lot of money. 75% of your trade should be win. 25% may be a loss. Hopefully, worst case, if you just say it like this, 75% will win, 25% will break even. And that's a good strategy to have. And if you can maintain that, then you would earn big money. One thing for sure. One thing for sure. This is also a nice thingy going on up here, if you ask me. 1 hour candle. You just do bullish and you just go to the moon. Make daddy happy. That's important. I can make the wife happy, and the wife is smashing with the credit card again. Where is the money? Where is the money? Well, the money is in the market, baby, and it's not coming out yet. But who knows? You never know what happens when you wake up tomorrow morning. It might have jumps. Jumps like this can also happen, of course. In a bullish way, it doesn't necessarily bearish the whole time. Although the last time it was like that, because this was March already, and there is more going down than going up, as you could see. Although you didn't start it today, let's be honest about it. And this is a nice push. It's also a nice push. You have nice push, that's a nice push. This is definitely a nice push. Thumbs up for those who traded this candle. Thumbs up for those who traded this candle. Oh yeah. Let's just see what the market is doing. That's the only thing you can do. And make some trend lines. That's and base them on your own gut feeling, and make your own strategy. Don't look at others, make your own strategy. You draw the lines on how you think they should be drawn, and you just do a little bit classical technical analysis. That's important. Try to learn about that and what they did in the past, and how you can transform that into something that will work in the future. And most of all now, of course, that's also important. And if you can combine that, if you can do that, you would end up with nice results. That's one thing for sure. I'm really convinced about that. I'm really convinced about that. And for this, I really don't know what will happen. It's around 450 now. We had the Fibonacci, right? We placed the Fibonacci a while ago. Was it a discharge? Ah, yeah, that was here a discharge. Eh? So remove the line. Yeah. Remove the line. President day chart. It was over a period of 20 days, eh? Including this one. Yeah, including this one, it's 20 days. And that's nice. We just have to see. You can also draw it like this. That seems, for me, it seems more logical, since the resistance and support that you see here, most of our resistance, of course, three of them are bouncing off. This one broke it. It's really, really, really choppy, this market. It's really, and I not today the candle also. I don't know what they want to do, but it seems like that the bulls are more present than the bearish guys. There's a 4,000 plus volume in this one. A 4,500 plus, 4,100 plus here, 5,300 here. Yeah, well, it seems like this would have a momentum going up, and hopefully it will hold, and it should break the 500 line somewhere around here. That is a target that I have on my mind. 500. It should break the 500 soon. It might even break that tomorrow, and Friday it might even be somewhere around here again. But who knows? If it is around 10 buck, maybe 15 buck. So that would be this level again up here. I want to close the trade, so I can move on also and do other stuff. But it is fun to make a video about long term trading and how it will develop over a period of time. It's funny to follow this and just to see how it evolves or develops, or how you even may say something like that. But yeah, well, there is not really much of an analyze that I can do. I still want to ask you to comment, thumbs up, like the video, dislike the video. I hope you like it, of course. Let me know what I can improve, so you would like it even more. Hit the subscribe button, hit the bell, so you will be notified of future updates. Let me know if you want me to make this live video on a different time, so you could actually also join live if needed, or if you want to, so we can have a chat during the video. I would love to have a chat with my community, because I'm sitting here also for you and not for me alone. Having a chat with you guys live, real time, while also analyzing the chat with the chart would be really, really fun to do. And maybe I can help you analyzing a chart that you're struggling with and learning you some tricks. Do know I'm not a financial advisor. I'm just doing this solely from my point of view. Always do your own due diligence, and ask your own financial advisor for advice. Always consult your own financial advisor. Officially, I'm not a financial advisor, but if you like, I want to be your financial advisor. But not for trading decisions. I can just tell you how to manage your trading portfolio or your wallet. I can tell you how to manage your income and your outgoing money. I will only tell you what I will trade, and if you follow me blindly, that's fine, that's up to you. But do know that I'm a high risk trader, and I'm learning to become a low risk trader. But yeah, the only way how to learn that is by doing stuff, and that's what I'm doing at the moment. I'm trying to learn as much as possible in order to become better and better and better on the long term and the short term, and as fast as possible. As fast as possible does not mean overnight. I hope it will happen overnight, but going too fast can also break you down. So I will be cautious. I will be careful with what I'm doing. Anyway, I hope you like the video again, because that's also important. And I hope I made it clear a little bit. So my current analysis is that this market is still just consolidate. If it breaks down here, then we all know what would probably go happen. For how long, I don't know, by the way, because it holds pretty nice on this level, so I don't think it would go down that much. It's just luring in people as far as I know, or maybe doing a stop hunt. Stop hunt is what you hear on the internet also a lot of times. Just to rise up and further and going up more. I based it solely on this because this level here is new, it's not being traded yet. And the market tends to go back to points where it is not being traded yet. And this whole area here is already traded. This whole area here is already traded. And if you want to go back to this point up here, well, then a lot of stuff needs to happen. I don't think that that would happen, honestly speaking. Why this happened is still something I don't know. It was at the end of the year. Well, here was also somewhere at the end of the year, month 12, and it only went up. It consolidated a little bit, but it didn't break like that. So what happened actually is something I really don't know. This is 18, 17, and this is 12, 17. This area up there. This is something I really wonder what happened. Even went up, consolidated only a little bit. There was still a stairs going up, and then more stairs. And where was this? This was in February. In February 18, something happened that the market made. Not do what it did in the previous time. So, if you guys knows what happened somewhere in the beginning of 18, please let me know in the comment. Maybe we can learn from it. Something must have caused this. World stress or housing stress or bed stress. I don't know, I'm just saying something. Maybe it is not even stress, but in the end something happened and the market didn't recover yet from a nice up. Bullish from a nice bullish push. Anyway, we were consolidating. We were analyzing the chart, and I think it is consolidating. Like it was here already, it would move on with this also. I still hope that this level would be broken, and a new higher high would be made so pretty soon. Because that's important, otherwise this can be a reversal in the market and then I don't know what is going to happen. Still see that that there is room for it to go up, so I will just leave it for one more night and just see what happens tomorrow. And I do know I take a risk on that because it might do stuff that we don't want it to do. But yeah, it bounces, it's only one breakdown up here. Breakthrough. It break through here again. It bounced. Supported, 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 bounced up, supported. So in the beginning, one, two, and it might bounce three. And then the final decision should be made. Or the final decision is already made and people are actually trading for a long position now at the moment. And then it's just a matter of waiting, and the market would steady go up, 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 up. Now let's just see. There is nothing else that I can add. There is no more added value for me to add to this video. And I will only make it longer and longer and longer, and that's also not really cool for you guys. I'm wasting your time. But my prediction for this is it will just consolidate a little bit, and yeah. It feels that this would break, but since this higher low is already being made, I don't know what will follow here. If it touches, then It might stay in the trend indeed and go down, down, down based on those 2 4-hour candles, which is usually also a pretty sign for stuff that I had in the past. Take this one, 4 hour candle, 4 hour candle, and you have a nice triangle up here, which is pointing downwards, and I don't like that at all. Downwards pointing triangle, or you may say something like that. Don't you guys know what I mean, right? Hey, what are you doing so weird? And I really don't like triangles that pointing down. But you never know what happens. It might consolidate and poof, go into this triangle up here, and actually make us some money. Anyway, some people might ask, why don't you just take this candle, or just take this candle, or in the worst case, take this candle. Because yeah, you just have to draw something, and you just have to be prepared on things that might happen. So I always consider other options that might happen, and because of that, I draw multiple options on the chart and analyze them all. I really analyze two things too more, too much, two things too much, then one thing too less, and end up with the wrong trading decision based on the wrong analyze. I hope I was enjoyable again. Please let me know in the comments. Please subscribe. Please like. And well, I hope to see you next time again. That will be tomorrow, of course. I hope I will be there at the same time. Because I might have an overtime to do. I don't know that for sure. But I will be online for sure, but it might be a little bit later. I will adjust the time if that is the case. I will already make the show. How do you say that? You planned. I will plan the show already for tomorrow 8 o'clock, so you could actually just set a reminder for it, if possible. And I will let you know if it will become a little later or not. Otherwise, just expect me to be there. And we will see what happened. Maybe the trade is closed, maybe not. I am not sure. Maybe I will just close it while we are doing the video for you to see. Rest me to say, have a very nice evening, nice night, nice morning, nice rest of the day, whatsoever. Look out the trading, what you're doing. And if you are in a trade that goes against you, just close it with the loss. It is still bearable for you. Otherwise, the loss might become non-bearable, and that is also not cool. Blowing up an account is not something that you like to do. It might take a long time for you to put up a new account with a lot of money that is hard-earned, which is not cool, of course. Anyway, we all make mistakes, and we all lose some money sometimes, but in the end, in the end, we need to earn money instead of losing money. That's the most important stuff. So again, subscribe my channel, like my channel, comment, let me know what I need to improve, what I don't need to improve. Let me know if you have any special wishes, and I hope to see you tomorrow again. Bye bye.